today we're making famous buildings. This is gonna be so fun. Do you wanna see what's in our kit today?
Yeah.
Okay.
In our kit today, we have modeling clay, toothpicks, and building cards.
This is gonna be so fun. On top of everything in your kit today, you might want a plate or a paper plate because that modeling clay can get kind of sticky and leave a residue on whatever you're building on. Also, if you wanna move your building around, it'll just crumble apart unless you have it on some sort of plate. So once you have that, we're ready to get started.
Woohoo!
Ella, do you know what it means to be an architect? An architect is someone that figures out how to design and construct a building. Mm-hmm. So like the Empire State Building, for instance, they didn't just start building it and see what happens. They had to have an architect figure everything out ahead of time and then they build it. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. So today we're studying architecture, which means the design and the process of building a building. So we're gonna take you on a little journey around the world with our architecture today. First, we're gonna start with this one. Can you read what that one is?
Egyptian pyramid.
That's right, the Egyptian pyramids are ancient pyramid-shaped masonry structures. That means they're made out of brick. They're located in Egypt. The real Egyptian pyramids are 455 feet tall. Next, we're gonna go to the Empire State Building. Do you know where that is?
New York City.
That's right. I've actually been to the top of the Empire State Building. Now, this is a very simplified version of the Empire State Building. If we tried to make the whole thing out of clay and toothpicks, it'd be a little impossible.
Yeah.
The top floor is 1,250 feet tall. Currently, it's the fourth tallest building in New York City and the sixth tallest in the US and the 43rd tallest tower in the world. The last building we're going to make is the Eiffel Tower. And you know where the Eiffel Tower is.
Paris!
That's right. And I've actually been to the Eiffel Tower before, and it is just as amazing as you would think it is. And at night, they light it up, and it's so pretty. And the lights shine on the river, and it's just beautiful. It's actually made of wrought iron. It's named after the engineer, Gustav Eiffel, whose company designed and built the tower. And it was purely for a tourist attraction so people could go and see the Eiffel Tower. And they were planning on taking it down after it was built, but they just kept it up. Aren't you so glad they kept it up?
Yes.
Yeah, so the Egyptian pyramids housed like tombs, you know, the dead pharaohs and that sort of thing. The Empire State Building is full of offices, actually. So people actually work in the Empire State Building, and then the Eiffel Tower is just for tourists so that you can take an elevator up and look around, and there's actually restaurants and things like that and gift shops inside the Eiffel Tower.
What? Yeah. I never knew that.
Yeah, there are. Okay, so we're gonna start today with the Egyptian pyramid. Now, when you're building your structures today, remember these are not made out of like blocks or Legos or something really sturdy like that. So we have to be actually pretty careful when we're making this because we're just using simple toothpicks and modeling clay. Okay, so you're gonna start with two toothpicks, and every time we put the toothpicks together, you're going to make a little ball of clay, okay? So you're gonna pinch a little ball and roll it in your fingers. You just roll it around like this and that'll make a perfect ball. We're going to take two toothpicks and make a right angle. If you're not sure what a right angle is, this card is a right angle. So right angle is what we use to make squares and rectangles, okay? And you're going to get another ball of clay, put it at the end of the toothpick, and put another toothpick into it. Basically, do you know what shape we were making?
A square.
So Ella was right, we are making a square. Make sure it's not sticking too much to your paper plate because we're gonna be moving the square later. Now don't get too frustrated. This is made out of toothpicks and clay, remember. So it will be kind of fragile, and as you're trying to move it around, it might come undone and you can just redo it. When you're doing any Winkle project, just keep going and keep trying. There's no such thing as failure unless you give up. Good, Ella, you got your square.
Yes, I did.
That's really nice. Okay, now you're gonna need a ball, and we're going to be making a triangle top on this square. So every toothpick we put in here is going to be leading up to this ball of clay in the middle. Nice. Now remember, you're going to try and lift this up every once in a while and make sure it's not sticking to your plate too much.
There we go. I did.
You did it. Good job. That looks really nice. If we ever get going too fast in any Winkle videos, you can always pause the video and press play when you're all caught up. If you missed any instructions or you didn't understand something clearly, just rewind the video and press play again. Okay, so we're gonna set these aside and now we're going to build the base structure of our pyramid. And that is going to look a lot like what we just built. We're going to build a larger square. Now, how would you build a larger square? We've got to connect the toothpicks together to make some straight lines. I ran out of orange clay, so I'm just going to start using my yellow clay.
Great, Ella, you have such a great square right there.
I did it.
That's great, good job.
Okay, now we're going to take our toothpicks and they're going to be pointing into the middle because this top is going to be right here and the toothpicks are going to be supporting them. Okay, so first we have to point all the toothpicks inward. All right, and now we get to put the top on. This part can be the trickiest. Just be patient and take your time. Each of those toothpicks that you have pointed towards the middle is going to go into a ball of clay that's on the underneath side of that first triangle prism that we made.
I did it! I did it!
Yay!
Yes!
Good job! That looks really good. Okay, we have made a wonderful Egyptian pyramid, don't you think? This is really awesome. It does come apart, so you can take a picture and then take everything apart and we can get ready for our next project. Next, we're going to New York City for the Empire State Building.
Ooh, ooh.
Yeah.
First, we're going to start with this rectangular base. So this is called a rectangular prism, actually. And this building's gonna be pretty big, so we actually need to go three across with our toothpicks. And this bottom that's down here, is actually like multiple levels of rectangles, meaning those are like tons of different layers of like shops and offices that are towards the bottom of the Empire State Building. And then as you get to the top, there's this long rectangle, like a rectangular prism. If you're having trouble with right angles, remember you can put your card in there to make sure that your structure is at a right angle. Very nice. Now, New York City was known for tall buildings, but at this time, all their buildings were only made out of brick and mortar. So to get a really tall building, you had to have really thick brick at the bottom of your building. And then it would go up and up and up and have really thin brick at the top. So to get a really tall building, you had to have really thick brick at the bottom of your building. And then it would go up and up and up and have really thin brick at the top. So like if you would walk into a really tall bank or something like that, the thickness of the walls at the bottom would be like 6 or 8 feet thick of a wall to support that structure. But when the Empire State Building came along, they started using steel construction. And steel construction changed everything because with steel construction, they could build really, really tall buildings. I'm making like a little lollipop like this and sticking it on top of every single piece of clay in my rectangle. At the top of the Empire State Building, it's actually very windy because when you get up that high, there's so much wind that you can actually start feeling the building like move. Yeah, pretty crazy, right?
Scary.
It can be, but also you have to know that people do it every day and it's very safe. Okay, now you probably guess what we're gonna do next, and that is we're gonna put a toothpick between each of our lollipops. These lollipops are known as support beams or support structures. When you're building something, especially something tall, you always have to have support structures or else the whole thing will just fall over.
All right, now we're gonna build the part that goes up, up, up. Ready?
Ooh, yes.
Okay, we just moved our base layer over to the side so that
we can build our tower, but you guys don't have to do that. This is just so that we can show you on the camera. So we have our square, and now we're gonna put a bunch of lollipops on top of those.
More lollipops?
Yeah, more lollipops. Yay. On top of those angles. Then we're gonna make more lollipops and put those on top. At this point, you could take this and put it inside your base structure. Now, this is gonna start getting wobbly, so we're going to put some supporting structures in our tower. So that is a lot more sturdy now that we have that. And then another lollipop tree. And then you guys can just keep building up and up and up until you want to, until you probably run out of clay and toothpicks. But if you want to make your tower taller and you're all out of supplies, you could remodel the base. I'll show you how. So I made the base a square, a cube, instead of a rectangle, and then that gives me more clay and toothpicks that I can use to make a taller tower. Now, I will warn you, the higher you get with your Empire State Building, the harder.
Wobblier.
Yes. And you have to think about the architects and the engineers that were in charge of the Empire State Building and how they had to figure out all of those problems before they even built it. These are awesome buildings, right?
I'm gonna wreck it.
I know. Take a picture first or show somebody so that you have proof that you made your building. Then we're going to take it apart and build our last building. You can just keep all your balls so that when we build our Eiffel Tower, you don't have to
make
new balls every time. Okay, now we get to do the Eiffel Tower from Paris, France. Okay, so do you see how the bottom of the Eiffel Tower is just on these four stilts like that? Mm-hmm. Yes, in reality, there's like a big arch on all of these, but we're not gonna build an arch with our toothpicks. But I do want you to double up on your toothpicks at the bottom. Okay, and the base is a square. So you're going to take all of your supporting legs that we just made. These are pretty much legs, right? And you're gonna make a square with them. So we're gonna tilt those out just a little bit because you see it's at an angle. The Eiffel Tower gets smaller and smaller as we go up. I'm going to just take a tiny piece of clay and put it in the foot of my Eiffel Tower so that these legs don't go crazy everywhere. We're gonna make some of those lollipops again.
Lollipop!
And stick them in, just going towards the middle a little bit. Okay, and then for this part, see how this square is large and this square is like a medium size and this one is really teeny tiny at the top? We have the big square right here and we have to make sure this square is a little bit smaller. So what we're gonna do is just break off the tip of the toothpick. Don't break it in half, just break off the tip. And you wanna make sure, of course we know in a square, all the sides are the same size. So if you line them up together and make sure they're all the same size. And now we can support these with our new toothpicks that we just created. If anything ever comes apart while you're doing it, just don't get frustrated, just put it back together. Good job, Ella. Okay, so we have our supporting legs, the large square, then some more supports, then the medium square, then what's next? What do you think about that? I think we're gonna have to put some toothpicks together with clay. We're gonna need four of them. We have our four sides here that are gonna be a long tower. In fact, if you want to make it three, that would be the harder version. I'm gonna make it three. You guys can just do two if you want. I think three will look even taller and more accurate, but that might be a little too difficult for some of you. If it's too difficult, don't worry about it. Just do the two. And hold on while I get these three ready. And then before we put those on here, we're going to build our square, our small square. So for our small square, we're gonna break the toothpicks in half. You actually only need two toothpicks. And we're gonna make our square right now. It's so tiny. All right, now we're gonna put in our tower pieces, pointing up. Don't worry if they're not pointing the right way. They will when we get that square on top. And then we put our square, our little smallest square on top. Look at that. That looks so good.
Very tall.
Yes, so Ella did the simplified version, which is totally fine. It's not quite as tall, but she got it. Good job. And I did the taller version. And then the Eiffel Tower has this long pole at the top. Buildings have long poles at the top for lightning, like it can be a lightning rod. A lot of times it's to signal airplanes, like they'll have a light on it that says, don't run into my building. And then they'll also be used for satellite communication. So that'll be broadcasting a signal or even receiving a signal. So if you want to put that on the top, what I suggest is you get a toothpick that's the right size. You break it down into the right size. Put a little piece of clay in the middle, and then you can put a toothpick just sticking out of the top. This is so great, Ella. You've become like your own little architect here. Very nice. I like your design. That looks so good. Now you guys, you've done three buildings that are famous buildings in the world. So now you can go and take the building down and make whatever kind of building you want. It could be based on another famous building in the world. It could be based on the house that you live in or the school that you go to. It's totally up to you. We'd love to see what you made. If you have a grown-up, take a picture or video of you making your famous building. Have them post it on social media, Facebook or Instagram. And they can tag us at the Winkle Crate. That way we can see what you made and how it turned out. Before you go, please like and subscribe so that you'll be the first to know whenever we make new Winkle STEM videos. Also, check out our links below. We have freebies and our website with a lot more STEM resources. Thanks for joining us today, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.
A building.
Have you seen Wreck-It Ralph?
I'm gonna wreck it!